Next finish is a limestone. Again, comes in a 5-gallon pail. The product is a 2-coat application at minimum in all cases. Comes as a tintable base. You'll tint it for the contractor typically. The first coat, you just burn a coat on. In other words, you're just color coding the surface of the wall. Again, there's some different techniques, and I'm sure all your field service guys can show you various ones, but the product as is will have a stiffer feel to it, stiffer viscosity, so the, rather than the standard finish. And that's normal, it should be that way. They don't want to throw a bunch of water to it. Again, when you're coating that surface, you'll see it's a very fine aggregate. And so this case, when I'm coating that surface, I've got my trowel up on angle. Just notice, it's not flat. I mean, I'm pulling it down just as tight as I can get it, so there's no fat or anything else left to it whatsoever. An easy way for them to gauge, if they haven't run it, then just pull the trowel back across it. And so you can see I'm not pulling anything back, but again, it'll just take them a little bit of, you know, a little while to kind of get used to the thickness. But all you're doing is just color coding that surface. So at that point, in many cases, you don't have to do too much to it if there's not a lot of trowel marks like it is in this case. But if there's any trowel marks, just take a float like this, not float the surface, and all you're actually doing is just eliminating any trowel marks. And then leave it alone, okay? Now, typically, under these kind of conditions, maybe 15 minutes. What you'll find is that right now, I can take my finger and I can disturb that surface. About 15, 20 minutes, when we look at the clock, roughly about 20 till 4, you'll see that I won't be able to disturb the finish. That's when it's ready to be coated again. So a lot of people ask, well, when do you put your second coat on? Generally, somewhere between 15 and 30 minutes, depending upon the environmental conditions. And then you're actually going to, when you put the second coat on, you'll notice that I go from this angle to this, and it'll smooth down just like a white coated surface. Then you immediately open it up, walk away from it, and if you want to make it perfectly smooth, then slide a trowel right across it one time and walk away. So with the second coat, now you'll just notice when I trowel it, can you see how smooth it lays down? It's like it grabs it, just because it's got a little bit of suction to it. And so that trowel is just very, very flat. And it basically just determines the thickness. Just like right now, I can't disturb it just that quickly. Okay? Once you get the entire panel covered, then there's multiple ways you can go about it, but I'll show you one. But you'll notice that I'm taking and going one direction on that last stroke. You don't want to open the texture up, different direction. So it's one directional. Now, most people will tell you that you don't have sufficient working time at that point. You've really got all kinds of time. It's not that you want to walk away and come back a half a day later, but you can actually clean up your tools. And the key is, in my opinion, you want to use this exact float. It's because of the type of the plastic. It picks up the aggregate very well. And so all you want to do is just rub the surface open. You don't want to make swirls into it. So when you start, you're just going to open it up. And then we can slide across it and make it perfectly smooth. And so like right now, it's a little bit wetter than what I'd want, so I'd just leave it alone. There's all kinds of time, okay? And so the key is just making sure that that trowel is flat. Go ahead and clean up your tools. And all you're actually doing is just rubbing that surface open. Once you get it open, you leave it alone. So you can imagine, with as fine as this finish is, your base has got to be perfect, guys. I mean, they've got to two-coat it. And so just like I'm rubbing, you can see that bore joint. Then you don't touch it. Now, a lot of people will leave it just like that, but what you'll see is I'll wait about 15 minutes and I'll try one direction over it and it'll be slick as glass. Then notice after I take a trowel and slide across that surface, again, one direction. Walk up, actually you can touch it now. It won't hurt, you know, it won't get stain your fingers, but you can actually feel how smooth it is. Feel it? And so all you're actually doing at that point you go one direction, walk away from it, never touch it. Okay? It'll have a mottled appearance as it dries, but when you walk up to it right now, you'll feel it's just very slick. You can actually hit it another time after, you know, let it go for an hour or two if you want. And so just like when I put my hand on it, you can feel how smooth it is right now. But the key is not messing with it, just like what I was doing. Put it on, lay it down, walk away from it. Don't touch it. Same way. Roughly 15 minutes. It was about 20 till. Slide across that surface, you're done.